This is a video report for a YouTuber named Sean K. I'm saying Sean K to keep his full name anonymous. And he contacted ClydeSight Productions because he saw a video on YouTube about a modification I did to a Yamaha PSS100 keyboard, and he wanted a similar modification. He has requested that I install a 1/4-inch mono jack for feeding to a external amplifier or mixer, plus a switch for cutting off the internal speaker so that he can use this in studio work. So I have received the instrument from him, and I'm checking it out now to see the condition of the instrument. It's in very good cosmetic condition. A little cleaning on the keyboard is necessary, and some polish on the case would be nice, which is easy to do. And in the back, we see there is no battery compartment cover. It does take 4 AA size batteries for a 6-volt system. I have put some batteries into the unit. The batteries will work without the cover, so we can go ahead and we can test it. So I turn the machine on. So we'll pick A1, which is supposedly a clarinet tone. So obviously that works. Go to A2, which is trumpet. And finally we'll do A3 for this sample. This is the saxophone. I'm not going to go through all of these on the video, but I will go ahead and test them. Now, to open the case, we lift it up very carefully because there is wiring connected underneath. And what we can see here is the keyboard, and here is the control strip, and here is for the battery. So the next step is to free the wiring for the battery. The wiring is held to the bottom of the case with strapping tape, and as soon as the tape is loosened, the spring for the battery comes right out, and this section can be lifted out just like this, thus freeing up the battery and making the bottom of the case removable for modifications. The modification involves the installation of 2 new parts, a switch here, which will cut the speaker on and off, and the mono jack. Now, the mono jack simply has a sleeve here and a tip connector, so that when a mono plug, standard tip sleeve type plug, is inserted into the jack, it makes contact like that. And that will then take the same signal that comes from the amplifier and send it to mixing board, an external amplifier, or anything you want to plug in. To make this whole system work, what's going to happen is the amplifier leads will go to the 2 tabs on the jack, and then a second wire will also go to the 2 tabs on the jack. It will then go to the 2 tabs on the switch, then a third wire will go to the other 2 tabs on the switch and return back to the speaker. The next step is to figure out where the switch and the jack are going to go. And because this wire from the amplifier board is so short, this jack is going to have to be as close as possible to the edge here. I'm going to locate it here, and the switch, we want to be close to it, so the switch will be here. Now, when I move this out of the way, you can see the switch and the jack fit in this part of the case, so it's away from all of this electrical connections here, so it will not interfere with them when the whole thing is flipped over like this and closed up. So now I'm going to mark the case and drill the holes and get everything mechanically ready to go. I have the holes drilled here, and you can see it's a very large hole for this switch. It's a much smaller hole for the jack. So the jack, which mounts from the inside, sits in the hole that way, but the switch has a locking thumb nut here that goes in from behind, so the switch has to mount from the outside in. That's part of the reason why I made so much extra wire and why I pre-soldered it. So I'm going to mount the switch first. So the jack is now wired and the heat shrink tubing is shrunk onto it, so it is a nice tight connection, and this will eventually go through this hole and lock down. The next thing I need to do is wire this to the speaker, and the electrical connections will be done. So I'll do that now. So the speaker is now wired, and it can go back into its location here and be bolted back down. The jack is mounted in the hole, it's locked down. I've taken the wire and wrapped it around these posts just to get it out of the way. I will leave the speaker wire free, and of course the battery wire is free. So the next thing to do is just simply reassemble the case and play with the machine or instrument. Okay, so let's play with this. I have a powered computer speaker here. It's part of a stereo pair, but since this is mono, we only need one. And I've got a cable here with a tip sleeve plug, which is what Sean has asked the jack manage. It's a mono plug, it's a mono jack. Plug it into the back here. So we turn on the instrument, press A1. So we're getting sound through this speaker here. Now I'm going to turn up the volume on this. Can you hear the difference? This is this speaker. Now, if we only want to hear that speaker, only that speaker, and nothing else. Before putting the case back together, I put a label inside the case that shows the circuit diagram for this output jack and speaker switch that I have created. I also put a set of instructions here that tell you that output instructions, the jack is always powered and the speaker switch, up is on, down is off. And here we have the modification. The switch and the jack. Now I'm going to show you how to polish this. It's a very easy thing to do. What you need is a can of WD-40. And the reason WD-40 works very well with this as a polish and a cleaner is because this is plastic, which is a petroleum product, and WD-40 is a petroleum product, so the two of them are very compatible. So what you do is you spray some on a towel, paper towel. Okay, and then you start rubbing gently on the keys and on the case and just let it soak on. You don't have to use a lot of it, but you want to put some on there. And you got to do every one of the keys, just very nicely rubbing the keys. Get inside, get underneath here, and do the top surface. It will not harm this at all. And get it all nicely rubbed on. And then once it's been sitting for about a minute or two, take a dry paper towel and you buff it just by rubbing it, just like you would a wax floor. And so some of the oil from the WD-40 gets into the plastic, which is what it wants because it helps preserve the plastic, and your towel will take off what's left over. And it also gets the dirt. So I'm going to go ahead and polish this up. So, this is ready to go back to Sean.